Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I'm going to directly follow up with the example where longtime viewer and supporter of the channel, Kobe, had given me this quick sort implementation to look at and was wondering why one version was faster than the other. Now, I completely blew your mind, I am quite sure, with the extraordinarily simple change that I made that resulted in a 10% performance improvement. I am going to blow your mind again with an even more surprising tiny change that will result in another 10% performance improvement. So I'm picking right off where I left off with the previous example, and we are at 1.2 times slower than the reference implementation of quicksort. Now, this change is going to be so incredibly subtle that you will probably go back and edit all of your previous code or audit all of your previous code that does something like this. I'm quite sure of it. So I've got this pivot in place function that is looking for the pivot point for the quick sort recursive algorithm implementation here. And if we look at this line, the for loop, now keep in mind, yes, this could be a ranged for loop. At the moment, it is not. But this comparison right here, elem less than end. Now, I know that I personally used to write all of my for loops that iterated over standard containers like this. At some point, someone pointed out to me, I do not recall when or where it was, that a more appropriate comparison is not equals. We don't actually care if the current element is less than the end. All that we care is that we reached the end or not. So 1.2 times slower, and I'm going to run my benchmark. Okay, we went from 1.2 times slower to 1.1 times slower. So again, almost another 10% performance improvement by going from a less than to a not equals. So of course, let's take this back into our compiler explorer example and see if we can figure out what's going on. Okay, so we have both versions exactly the same. We have this less than here, and we have a comparison with GCC trunk between the two versions, and they are identical. Now I'm going to change our second version. So the first one will be the reference one. I'm going to change the second one to have this not equals to, and let's see what changes. Wow. Okay. More than I expected. A lot just changed all over the place. So the second version is the one that we know this faster, the one on the right hand side. Let's just verify that. Yes. Editor number two is the one that's on the right hand side, and it is 9 instructions longer, which is counterintuitive. In some of these cases, we expect fewer instructions often times in the faster version of the code. So let's see if we can try to figure out what we saw. Now, I think we did a pretty good job last time. Let's see, compare jump if, what is JNB? Oh, well, okay, I know it's a jump instruction. Okay, whatever. This is does a jump of equal. So it's like starts right out the gate with completely different logic. And we can see that the things that are highlighted in yellow are the things that refer to this specific loop. So that is here, compare of RDI and RSI, compare of RAX and RSI, RAX and RSI. And this is in our slower version. Okay. It's doing an actual equals comparison here in the faster version. And in the slower version, it is doing a comparison. And then let's double check what JNB is. Okay, JNB, jump if not below. So it's an unsigned comparison, and it's saying check if it's not less, the jump if it's not less than. Okay, so it's doing an actual signed comparison, and here it's doing a equals comparison. And this is also doing a JB. It's doing another actual like it's doing a less than comparison. It hasn't optimized that away. And here it's doing an equal to comparison. Now, why it shifts off these other things is an entirely different question. And this is where the other extra instructions seem to come into play here. It's not any additional comparison. It is zeroing out R8 and shifting some things around between R10 and RSI. It's also using R10 here. Nothing jumps out as an immediately obvious problem here. Doing some address calculation kinds of things. It almost just seems like the entire difference in performance comes down to the inversion of this logic. So jump if not less than to L2. L2 is down here. And this one says jump if equal to L5. So this is where it's escaping from the loop. This is also where it's escaping from the loop. Okay. So it mostly, it's doing the same escape from the loop, but apparently this comparison is more efficient. The one where it's doing a not equal to comparison is more efficient. And that's, maybe counterintuitive, but it also more correctly expresses the intent of the code. Let's go back to our actual example here, because we have to ask the question of what happens if we just use a ranged for loop instead, and how does that compare? We're at 1.1 times slower now. All right, so that didn't change the performance at all. Let's look and see if it changed the compiled code. Now, I'm going to make it so the left-hand side is now the not equals to, and I'm going to make it so the right-hand side is using the ranged for loop. So that's the ranged for loop, and well, all right. It would seem that that generated the exact same code as trying to get the loop correct on our own. So again, this is a case where just simply following the best practices gives us another 10% performance improvement. So I hope you enjoyed these last couple of episodes where I looked into these changes that seemed just completely unexpected for the amount of impact that they could have. And be sure that, you know, you follow the best practices. And you can check out my book, which is linked, about C++ best practices, right here in the description of this video. And be sure to leave a comment and leave your thoughts and subscribe to this channel.